Yo, you guys, this is Blacklist of the Abyss, and you're watching my live reaction for Dororo, Episode 1. Okay, the Osamu Tezuka manga, now recreated in animation. Alright, I've heard some good things so far. I've heard some good things, not any, like, plot-related details, but I've heard some good things, so I'm looking forward to watching this episode. And, stick around after the video for some discussion about it. And yeah, you guys, Episode 1. Something tells me he's gonna do it anyway. Something tells me he's gonna do it anyway. Well, there you go. He tried to get away. Wasn't gonna happen though, dang. I mean,
it seems to me you've already accepted it, though.
Like, you're telling yourself you wanted this to happen before you believed something, but it looks like you already believe it. Like, so if you would just say something, then he wouldn't. Is it dead or no? It's alive, but okay. So that's clearly the price he paid. So he didn't think it extended to other people. I mean, it has, like, you should probably do something about that lack of skin, though, like. You sure you want to be telling them that? Nice. I heard good things about this opening. It's very, it reminds me of Angomwa, mainly because of the filter that they're using. It's kind of similar to what Angomwa used, if that's even how it's pronounced. The Mongol invasion anime from a couple seasons ago. I'm so serious. This is a great opening, though. Nice. Okay. He's got a sword for an arm. Nice. Nice. These are great visuals. These are seriously great visuals. It instantly comes off as one of the better anime of the season, just like by opening alone. Of course, you can't tell that just from an opening, because there are a ton of shows that have great openings but are actually bad, but this actually looks really good, so I'm looking forward to seeing more of this. Yeah, this isn't going to go the way you plan. Are we going the Moses route here? Are we pulling a Moses? Just gonna push him down the river to whoever finds him and then have them raise him? Alright, cool. And that's how our main protagonist was born. dang. Oh, dang. Wow. Okay. Wow. I mean, you're not wrong. That was impressive. No, that was impressive.
Interesting.
Oh, he's got a whole bunch of them too. Nice. Finding a way to make it in this world, huh? Good job. Good job. Is a bunny girl gonna walk in? Is a bunny girl just gonna show up out of nowhere? Just walk on into the scene? Just give in. You know you want to. Just do it. Just give in. Oh wow, so we actually caught up. I'd let go of him if I were you. So he didn't actually have a mask on. The kid just thought he did because the guy's got a face like a doll. He's a Bishonen. By a child. Oh, give it time. You'll see it soon. I tried to warn you, man. You should have paid more attention. And now you've been eaten by a blob. Ayakashi thing. And it ignores him? Because why? Because he wasn't moving? Is that... yes, I guess it's movement based. Yo. So this guy's pretty much freaking Helen Keller. This dude's literally Helen Keller. Okay, he does. Oh, okay, that is a mask. So he just like got his skin back? I have no idea how to take that. Oh, look at him. Look at him. Still looking to the gods. Still looking to Buddha. What you gonna do, huh? Now what? Oh, so she did end up having another kid. I thought the Buddha would have prevented her from ever having kids again. I guess I had kind of assumed that he had made the limbs and stuff for him, but I guess that's confirmation. Wow, that was episode 1 on Dororo with my bad Japanese accent. That was interesting. I'm very intrigued. I'm very intrigued to see where this goes. I'm intrigued to learn more about Hyakkimaru. The series isn't even named after him, though. It's named after Dororo. So is Hyakkimaru really the main character? Who knows? I mean, there have been other shows that have been named after other people, and they've not been the main characters. Right? This isn't exactly a first, so... I'm interested in seeing what the dynamic between these two is. I'm interested in seeing where the story goes, because there's clearly a lot going on here in terms of the Buddha, the gods, the pact that was made with the demon. Like, there's clearly some stuff going on here that's going to play out. But as far as, like, overarching plot that doesn't include that, that stuff, I'm not really sure where it's gonna go. So I'm interested in seeing episodes 2 and 3 and just getting a feel for what the show wants to do. When I watched Boogie Pop, I essentially said something similar, where I needed to see another episode just to get a feel for what the show was trying to accomplish and what it was trying to do, what direction it was going in. And I feel the same way with this. I have a general idea, but in terms of, but it's like very, very general. Like, I know a couple of things are going to be touched on. I just don't know what the actual direction is to get to that point where those aspects of getting touched on. Obviously, the Hyakkimaru is going to meet up with the father and the mother and the brother, right? At some point, that's going to happen. But what's going to lead them to meeting up? What is Hyakkimaru currently doing? Fighting against the Ayakashi? How did that arise? Like, stuff like, I'm interested in seeing this story actually built out, because there's clearly something here, but we only got like bits and pieces around. I'm interested in seeing them all get connected and then build towards something else. But yeah, Dororo, very interesting. Osamu Tezuka, famous father of animation. All right, so like I'm definitely interested in keeping up with this show. I don't know if I'll continue doing live reactions for it, just because I have a lot on my plate. And I've been saying this with like every live reaction I do, that I have a lot on my plate right now. I don't really have time to keep up with all these live reactions, so I'm probably going to drop a couple things. I already had to drop Boogie Pop. One, for a couple reasons, one of them being that it's more of a review show than a live reaction show. It just doesn't, the way this plot is structured, it doesn't really, it doesn't lend itself well to reactions as opposed to reviews. But at the same time, YouTube blocked both of my live reactions days after I had uploaded them. It's just not really, for the views I get for them, it's not really worth the effort of constantly re-editing and re-uploading and checking back every day to make sure that YouTube hasn't blocked it, since usually when YouTube blocks a video, it happens like the second it gets uploaded, so you know, and you can start re-editing right away. But with this, it didn't block the two episodes until days later. So I would actually have to keep checking, because YouTube does send you emails, but that stuff kind of gets lost in the shuffle sometimes. So I'd actually have to keep checking YouTube every day, multiple times a day, just to make sure that the videos haven't gotten blocked for Boogie Pop, and it's just not really worth it. So in the end, I've dropped Boogie Pop, Dororo. I'm not sure if I'll keep up with my reactions for it. I'm definitely keeping up with Mob Psycho and The Promised Neverland. And I'll see what else I end up adding to that. Oh, and JoJo's as well, obviously, Golden Wind. But I'll have to see if anything else gets added to that schedule. It might just be those three. I might add something else on. We'll have to see. I do have a couple other reactions that I've done for episode ones. And by the time this video gets uploaded, hopefully they haven't been... hopefully those haven't been blocked either. But, yeah. That's it for Dororo. And yeah, you guys, that's that. Like, comment, subscribe, follow me on Twitter at BlacklistOTA, and I'll see you guys next time.